talking about sales, and I want to go over what's the biggest thing that information marketers need to overcome in order to close a sale. And this is true for consultants as well. When you're up against someone and you're wanting to convince them to go with you, you have to deal with competition, of course. You have to deal with the credibility. You have to have established yourself as an expert. But even more importantly, you have to deal with the fact that that person that you want to teach doesn't believe themselves that they can do the job. Let's say, for example, someone trying to lose weight. It's a really good way to kind of illustrate this. If I need to lose, let's say, 50 pounds, it's really important for anyone working you through that program to get you a quick win. They need to get you to lose, let's say, 8-10 pounds in 4 to 6 weeks so that you yourself say, hey, I can do this. You've helped them get past the mental block that they had that convinced them that this was just a monumental task that they could not do. Let's say, for example, someone who's like the fourth in a foursome, and they're like the worst golfer in their foursome, and they get teased for it, and they're the ones that's the butt of all the jokes. They get up, and you know, they've got this huge slice problem that they got to deal with. And let's say that they say, you know what, I got to fix this problem. I want to improve my game. Well, if you're the golf pro that, you know, trying to train them, you've got to get them some quick win, just like the weight loss person that says, look, let's reduce your score by 5 points, or let's reduce your score by 10 points in 6 weeks, by either working on your short game, on your putting, you know, whatever it is. But you need to get them that success quickly so that they don't just believe in you. More importantly, they believe in themselves that they can make progress against this goal. So whenever you're working on something that you want to teach, you're up against a big handicap because you know your topic super well. And then we have a tendency to do things like, you know, like let's say the golfer. Well, you can work on your putting, you can work on your short game, and you know, you can work on your stance and all these things. And before you know it, this person who's already got an issue thinking they can't do it is now on top of underconfident, is overwhelmed because they're kind of going, where do I even start? And so they're looking to you for your, you know, the coach, you know, or the trainer to help give them the roadmap, to help, you know, define the direction, the journey that someone has to take to get from where they are right now to where they want to get. You get the quick win first, and then you can start expanding on all the information you can possibly teach them. But you really have to hold back from giving way too much information because you start freaking these people out. They go into overwhelm mode. They basically get that deer in the headlights look. And then at that point, they're saying, forget it. I'm not going to buy anything. And then you don't win. Your competitor doesn't win. Nobody wins. So that's something you really need to think about so that when you put your course together, you're pushing your students to that quick win, which is what they need in order to get to their real success.